Like, Robo, after he went through, I could feel the gratitude coming from him once he went through that portal. Felt so much relieved and at peace. But a crypt came to show him around. That's what I saw. I seen in my mind, a crypt came, you know, like, you know, maybe the person who killed him. You never even know. I've seen that before. And, you know, the person who killed the other person, if that person dies, the person that killed them, if that person who killed them is on the other side, they'll come to help you out. Yeah. I've seen that happen with gangbangers.
Greet you
and stuff, and, mm-hmm. and show you, and yeah. That's what I see with gangbangers all the time. Like, you know, it's all forgiven. You know, there's still, let me say, there's still a lot of them repping their sets, even on the other side. That's all right with God. Mm-hmm. They're wearing the red, they're blue, whatever it is, yeah. You know? Like, you know, this dude's got his red bandana on, you know? He looks just like a friend of mine named Andrew, you know? He looks a lot like him, you know?
I mean, we've seen him on the other side drinking and smoking blunt.
Yeah, we saw Bloods having a party. The video is on YouTube. It's called Chilling with the Bloods. That's what the video is called.
They were drinking beers and stuff like that.
That's what they wanted us to call it. They had champagne popping open. They were at a huge party. Just because they were feeling good about themselves.
That's right.
These guys are from California too. I remember that now. All of these
California would go, yeah,
they were cheering. Like, we'd say something positive. We'd be like, you know, no one's being punished and all that.
Yeah.
You know, every time something true would come out, they toast to it, champagne glasses slamming together. And,
yeah, you
know, I remember that. That's
what they wanted to be doing. So.
And I was all right with God.
Yeah.
And I remember even seeing Christ and Buddha stopping through the party. After that. I saw them coming through, you know, both of them together. You know, Lord Buddha, Lord Christ together, just stopping through, checking in on them because they were around us. We saw us doing that. They stopped by to show love and all. You know, and, you know, even them, they don't mind. You know,
I don't see any of them looking down on anybody.
I remember Christ said to us one time in the video that's on one of our videos on YouTube, it's on there. He said something like, he's seen all walks of life.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm sure the same goes for Lord Krishna, Lord Buddha, Lord Muhammad.
Yeah.
You know, and all of them, you know, they've seen it all, heard it all. So, you know, if you're cussing and said stuff like that, or even like for those of y'all who killed people, you know, hurt people, you know, done bad things, you know, think, and you feel bad, don't worry. Like, this is what this coming down to. You know, people in this life are going to condemn you. There'll be people who are going to try to judge and condemn you. People are going to hate on you. You know, regardless of if you're locked up or if you're on the street, you know, regardless of where you are, you know, it's always going to be someone judging. You know, in this world, but then in the next, it's different.
I think it's a lot different, yeah. You know, I think in this world, people judge you and make you. I mean, I guess, like, you know, we're talking about killers and stuff, but even, you don't have to be even a killer to be looked at as, like, you know, people will call you names and things, all this judgment, you know. You don't need that, take that and run with it or anything.
Just let it fall off of you.
Yeah.
Let that judgment just slide off of you like you have, like that pan with the, what's the pan thing?
Like a nonstick pan.
Yeah, like a nonstick pan, it slides off.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you know, the same thing. Just let it slide off of you. Like, you have a shield around you that's slit.
Absolutely.
Like, someone throws the eggs at you and it's splattering on you or something. And it's sliding down. It's not hitting you. Don't let it hit you.
May not be the most flattering thing, but let it go. You know?
Whatever it is, regardless of what they're saying, say anyone. Just go to anyone.
You're a walking God yourself, you know?
That's another truth. Everybody's a God. Everybody's a Lord. Mm-hmm. You know, like everyone is.
We all create our own reality. It's just, you know, down to Jesus, to you and me, mm-hmm. and many of you guys. You create your own reality. It's just a difference of speed.
Yeah, and how much you remember at the moment about it.
Right.
And, you know, if you gain full remembrance, you know, then, you know, you've really moved into the state of Godhood, Lordhood.
Exactly.
You know, and you remember it while you're living a life instead of forgetting it. That's the object of these physical lives here. We're just living life after life, you know, trying to get to that point where we remember what we're really about loving each other.
Yeah.
And remember it while you're living the physical life. Once you remember it and you live it, then you don't need to keep coming back. the physical life incarnations in this world or other worlds in the universe.
Yeah.
You don't need to do that if you don't want to.
That's right.
You know, you don't have to anyway, you don't want to, but your spirits can develop a lot quicker by living physical lives.
I've learned that. Kind of knocking them out and getting them over with.
That's what Jeremy and I have done. Jeremy and I have had, I think, I see there were tens of thousands of lives.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, between a tens and tens of thousands of lives. You know, physical lives. And this is our last one.
Yeah.
We even call this our very last physical life.
Yeah.
You know, if we're finished after this, we've learned what we've had to learn.
Yeah.
This is it.
Hopefully this is beneficial. I believe so. You know, it's beneficial that we know what we know now.
We've come a long way.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, we're not going to talk about it now, but if you heard about what we've done and what we've seen in our past lives, you'll see what we're talking about, about forgiveness and about redemption and, you know, learning and stuff and sinners turning into saints and hate. We've done some crazy stuff in our past lives. We've been through our past lives, a lot of them. Oh, man.
Most likely what you fear the most.
We've done good. We've done bad.
Yeah.
You've probably already done it.
Yeah.
And another thing is, like, I know we could talk about past lives another time, but since we brought it up, a lot of our people you're around now, you lived lives with before. Your friends now, some of your family, people you're around, you've been in lives with them before.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they've been your parents, so your friend could have been your mother before.
Yeah.
Like, Jeremy's been my wife before. Jeremy's been like a woman before a man. I've been woman, man. Y'all have been. Jeremy's been my husband, wife. You know. Tony's been my son. Like a lot of my friends have been my sons in other lives and daughters. Yeah, the friends that I the friends in this life or family or you know. One of my friends was my wife in a couple lives. A girl I knew in this life who was just a friend.
I was gonna say that. Yeah, like, you know, we've talked about a lot of our past lives and stuff. We'll do that sometime more, of course, but...
We'll do that. That's something else we can do for you. We can see past lives a lot of the time with people. I see them particularly clear. We both do. We can just see them pop up like a little movie in our mind. And we think that we see what's past life in person, and it pops up.
Very interesting.
Well, we got about 4 minutes left on this one, but, you know, I just saw this written down here. Something I just had words pop into me earlier. Something about, all right, we were talking about, this goes for everybody, not just killers and stuff like that. That we talked about, you know, I don't know, I wrote down, be easy to yourself and others. Words that popped up into my mind while we were doing the first video earlier. You know, something about be easy to yourself, be easy, and be kind. You know, it's something to learn. You know, you can do something to start practicing. It doesn't matter when. You know, it doesn't mean it can be any time. But just, you know, take what you've done. You know, if you've done something real bad, you know, we're here to, look, we're here to help. You know, so you need someone to talk to. Like we said earlier, another one, we're not telling anybody's business.
Yeah, that's a way.
You never need someone to talk to, regardless of anything. Anybody can call us and talk about anything.
There's a way of healing. There's an answer. There's an explanation for your thoughts and things. You know, and sometimes we feel fit that we're the ones that can help. So we're trying to. You know, that's the best we can do.
Yeah.
I want to emphasize it's the best we can do all the time because it's not easy, but we're doing it.
That's right. That's right. Yeah, we do the best we can, so, you know, but we're here to just, like I said, we hope that y'all learned something from this one, too. And we're about at the 20-minute mark on this video, so we're going to take a quick break, and then we got some other things we're going to talk about, too. So, all right, I'll see y'all in a few minutes. Peace.